Is relativity space in trouble? A recently published Bloomberg article on relativity space claims they are facing a cash drain. The story is the company is running short of cash, is getting more challenging to raise money from investors, a problem other space startups are facing. Sarah Lawson, a spokesperson for Relativity Space, said the company doesn't comment on speculation and that Relativity Space is fully committed to the development and launch of Terran R. She added, "We continue to make significant progress toward our 2026 launch target and are confident in our ability to bring this innovative vehicle to market," she said. Other firms who received large influxes of cash in the blank check deal frenzy a few years ago are now buckling on the stress of their high valuations. Virgin Orbit filed for bankruptcy in 2023, Astra Space has gone private, and Axiom Space is struggling at the moment. Relativity Space is well known for its 3D printers. Its Terran 1 vehicle is 85% printed. Unfortunately, with the larger Terran R, large amounts of capital are needed to finance the development of the Stargate printers, which have faced technical challenges. In an X post, Sebastian Asprella, co-founder and former CEO and shareholder of Think Orbital, made some interesting observations that apply to Relativity Space and other similar space startups. He said, "Relativity Space's struggle underscores the harsh realities of the small launch market. While they push the envelope with 3D printing approaches, technical novelty doesn't guarantee commercial success, especially in an industry where cost-effectiveness, reliability, and scaling are paramount. Here's why their future looks challenging." He speculated that the future will be challenging for Relativity Space and other space startups. Here's the list of challenges he outlined. High burn rate with limited revenue. Rocket development is capital intensive, and Relativity has yet to establish a consistent revenue stream through frequent, reliable launches. The cash burn, especially in the R&D-heavy early phases of 3D printed rocket technology, could quickly outpace investment interest, especially in a tightening economic environment where investors are risk-averse. Consider the expenses involved. Purchasing specialized equipment, like massive 3D printers, which are some of the largest in the world, and that's just the beginning. There's also the need to construct and equip factories, establish test facilities, either by leasing or building those structures from the ground up. Additionally, the workforce required, highly skilled engineers and technicians, are in high demand across various sectors, commanding salaries that reflect their expertise. Unproven launch cadence and reliability. Clients in the space industry require a proven track record before they will risk their valuable payloads with a new launch provider. Relativity Space, while innovative, has not yet established a consistent launch schedule or reliability that companies like Rocket Lab or SpaceX have achieved. Rocket Lab, for instance, has launched 54 times and established itself with private companies, NASA, the US Department of Defense, and Space Force. Launch failures are almost expected with new rocket vehicles, which makes it challenging for Relativity to attract customers. Without customers willing to take the risk with their expensive satellites or experimental payloads, Relativity's success is uncertain. The company must demonstrate a regular and successful launch cadence to build the necessary trust and market presence. Next, let's address the 3D printing issue that Relativity Space is so well known for. Questionable economic viability of 3D printing. While 3D printing offers clear benefits for prototyping and creating specific intricate components, scaling it for full rocket production is questionable. Traditional manufacturing, while less agile in terms of design changes, have reached cost savings that 3D printed components will find difficult to match at scale. No one else in the industry is making such an extensive use of 3D printing as Relativity Space is. That should give the company pause. It isn't at all clear that 3D printing large fuel tanks is beneficial. What advantages does it provide? Indeed, we reported in September that Relativity Space is reconsidering how much of its medium launch vehicle should be 3D printed. There is an urgency for them to meet market demands, and they already have a substantial backlog, reportedly amounting to $2.6 billion in orders. Reusability gap. SpaceX's dominance is heavily tied to reusability, which allows them to spread costs over multiple launches. In today's launch market, to truly compete, a company must either have a reusable first stage or be actively developing one for future use. SpaceX's market leadership is largely due to their ability to reuse the first stage of their rockets, dramatically lowering the cost per launch. This allows them to offer competitive pricing and still make a profit. For instance, SpaceX has successfully reused some first stages 20 times already. By spreading the cost of manufacturing across 20 launches, they effectively reduce the cost by 95%. Their ambition now is to increase this to 40 launches per booster. Meanwhile, Relativity Space, while focusing on optimizing simpler components like fuel tanks, might benefit from redirecting more resources towards critical technologies such as reusability. If Relativity does not prioritize and make swift progress in this area, they will be at a severe economic disadvantage. Crowded small launch market. The small launch sector is getting more crowded by the day. What SpaceX doesn't win with its transporter rideshare missions are scooped up by Rocket Lab and their Electron vehicle. These companies have established good working relationships with all the customers in the satellite sector, making it difficult for new and unknown players to build market share. Think about it. If you had a new satellite ready to launch, would you opt for a well-established launcher like SpaceX's Falcon 9 or Rocket Lab's Electron? Or take a chance on a new, untested company, even if they offered a lower price? Market dynamics favoring larger, reusable vehicles. A big problem all launch companies face is SpaceX and their rideshare missions. These missions can launch 100 satellites in a single launch. The cadence of missions from SpaceX is simply unmatched. With Starship looming on the horizon, offering payloads of 100 plus tons, fully reusable, higher operational cadence, and possibly lower launch costs, the future will be highly competitive. However, SpaceX can't meet every satellite launch demand, which leaves an opening for smaller providers. These companies might find success by focusing on specialized services, like targeting unique orbits, providing rapid launch turnarounds, or offering niche capabilities not yet addressed by SpaceX. And finally, execution risk and technological hurdles. Designing, building, and testing rockets is one of the hardest technical achievements possible. Relativity has compounded this task by adding the extensive use of 3D printing on all components with unclear benefits. This adds to schedule uncertainty, structural and mechanical issues with novel 3D components, performance inconsistencies, and investor concern. Relativity risks alienating customers and investors if it prioritizes technical innovation over operational speed and reliability. The focus on technological advancement might be seen as neglecting customer-centric values like rapid execution and low-risk operations, potentially deterring partnerships and investment. Companies with streamlined processes and customer confidence will win. Relativity needs to remove unnecessary roadblocks to progress, focus on execution, and get their rockets on the launch pad for their customers and investors to see. What's your take on Relativity Space's current progress? Do you believe they'll achieve success with their medium launch vehicle, set to debut in 2026? Leave your comments below. That's it for this week. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe. From rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more, if it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.